Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Sip and Sync with Azure. Today, we're going to be talking about Project Stormbreaker with Diego. Let me just call him up for a second. Hi, Diego.
Hey, Eleanor. What's up?
Just getting on with the episode. So we're going to be talking about Project Stormbreaker. Could you tell us a little more about it?
I can definitely do it. So Stormbreaker is a project that we've put it together with some of the industry experts in the area on how to use Azure Kubernetes Service to simulate large weather systems.
So like to prevent floods, plan for disasters, forecasting, evacuation?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's the core idea there. I think actually it might be easier. I do have a diagram, if it's okay, if I can share that with you.
I'd love to see it.
Yeah, let me bring that on the screen here. Okay, so again, to your point, I mean, why are we doing this here? It is to simulate these large weather systems and to either predict or, you know, if we have to go back and look at a weather system that hit us, what happened and how can we actually prevent that in the future? What we have here at its core, it's Azure Kubernetes Service. That is a monitoring stack in place that is pretty much the standard, if you will, or you know what the most popular stack for cloud native. I'm using Grafana and Prometheus to get metrics from this cluster. In the cluster itself, we're using these really large SKUs with AKS. They are the HB120 from AMD, so that gives us up to 120 cores. For this demo here, I'm going to show you three of them. And behind the scenes, to actually orchestrate these traditional HPC workloads, I'm using something called Volcano. Volcano is an open source project that allows you to actually get, again, this workloads that you would traditionally go with something like CycleCloud or other HPC solutions out there. But instead, you can use Kubernetes for that. So I'll show you how this whole thing works. We have some other things in here, such as KEDA, the Kubernetes Event-Driven Autoscaler. You can see those in here. And they, with Service Bus, will allow us to showcase a pattern using event-driven architecture to schedule these jobs on and off. Are you ready for some demo?
Yeah, I am.
All right. I'll circle back on this later because I want to show you some other stuff. Okay, so what do we have here? Right now, what you're seeing in the black terminal here, I'm using K9s to plug back into my AKS cluster. And then I see my running containers in there. Of interest here for this demo, I have a front end and an API, and I'm doing a port forward, so I'm doing an SSH tunnel back to the cluster so I can demo that to you. We'll come back to this in a second. I wanna show you my very nice terminal.
I can hear
you getting very excited about this.
Super excited.
Okay. Let me show you how to create a job. There are a few ways you can do this. I mean, this is, again, just showcasing a pattern. So customers or folks who want to try this, they can come from the web, like what I'm doing here right now. So this can be fully on your browser, or you can do this through CLI. From the web here, let's suppose we're simulating this with the city of Miami, and I'm going to choose between what I have here. I'm going to take Katrina, choose one of the SKUs. I'm taking right now the smallest SKU on the HB120, but you can go into the full size, which is actually 120 cores. For now, just using 16 cores. We need three nodes for this. I'm gonna say 36 cores, and then in each one of these nodes, in each one of the virtual machines, we're gonna allocate 12 cores. Once you hit save, you now have a job created here, right? Behind the scenes, what is happening is KEDA, the Kubernetes Event-Driven Autoscaler, will come online, the dispatcher in here, will go to Service Bus, and it will retrieve a job from there. That job now gets spread across these three different nodes. We can see it's running. This is actually the actual simulation for Katrina, the one that I have it in here. You can kind of see it's about 40% going. Once that's done, we'll have all of that information essentially crunched back and then ship it over to blob storage. These jobs in here were initiated by Volcano. So that's an interesting point to bring to this. And we can do some sort of accounting on the jobs after the fact as well. So we can see how much time it takes for a certain job to run. Once this is all done, what you're going to see here is that all the jobs will get cleared. Kata will come back and then go back and clear all of the areas that are needed here, like go back to service bus and remove things from there, right? All the jobs. Mm-hmm. That's it. That's completed in there. Now, if we go back to this view, from an operator scientist point of view, they would have all of the output and the results from this simulation in the output folder. So you have, you know, a nice a structured way to go and see, hey, City of Miami, you know, the simulation I ran today for Katrina, it's available for me in this output, so then it can further analyze.
That's really cool and involved. And you mentioned Volcano is the HPC scheduler?
A scheduler, yes, it is. So it is the HPC scheduler. I will go back here in a second. I will share this with you. Mm-hmm. But in our GitHub repo, you will be able to find a lot of the information that I just showed you, including how to tweak Volcano to your own purposes. So one thing I want to say is that this platform, although I'm showing that we can do weather simulation, can be used for other things like simulating other traditional HPC workloads. Two things here that I think you're going to find quite interesting. I'll pick you just a challenge here for you. Okay. As I show you this, this whole simulation working, I think one core aspect of this, outside of Volcano per se, is, well, we have to containerize, right? This needs to run, this model, HPC model, needs to run in a container. I want you to guess what language you think this was written.
Don't
I'll give you a few options
guess.
Here. This could be done in C, in Python, or in Fortran. So
I'm definitely better at Python.
It's really Fortran, and it's not something we typically come across. But I'll leave, you know, in the GitHub repo, if you go and if you search there, I have an area that all of the Docker builds are located, and you can see how that whole thing worked out. One last thing I want to show you here in this demo is that, again, this is real time. This is the Grafana dashboard that is pointing to this specific cluster, and we can see when a job runs, what happens in terms of CPU utilization, memory, and network and whatnot. So it's, again, fully instrumented from the get-go.
Well, this has all been super impressive. And if anyone wants to know more about this project, we have links to the GitHub in the description. Is there anything else you want to leave us with?
No, please feel free to contribute back. We're always looking for collaboration. So I'd appreciate that.
All right, great. And thank you for coming onto the show, Diego. And thank you all for tuning in to Sip and Sync with Azure. Until next time, let's keep sipping that coffee and syncing with Azure.